Bradley, so going into this fight, there has been a lot of change in your camp from trainers. Usually when fighters make a change in trainers, they're not the same. But how difficult has it been dealing with the criticism the boxing community has been dishing out your way for the switching trainer?
No criticism. It's just everybody's thoughts. It's everybody's feelings. It's everybody's opinion. That's just life. That's just the nature of the sport, the nature of being a professional athlete. Everybody's gonna criticize you every move you make, but as long as you happy with the move you made, as long as I'm content, as long as I know exactly what I'm doing and what I want, it doesn't matter what anybody else say, it's about me. And I'm happy, I'm glad I made the change, and Teddy Atlas is one of the best trainers in the world.
I know you said whatever Diaz has to say or whatever strain there's in that relationship is bridged under the water, but recently you stated that in 3 days you learned more than what you learned in 10 years with Diaz. Isn't that kind of, taking a jab at
that's
him?
That's not even a jab. That's just factual. That's just factual stuff. That's not taking a jab or anything. I'm not throwing no jabs at that man. It's just, I'm being honest. I was just being honest. And that's how I felt at the time. And, if you know, he wants to take it that way, it's okay. I mean, he can take it however he wants to take it.
What's your take on the Rios camp stating that there has been mentioned a fight with Canelo, being that your fight with him hasn't even passed? We don't know the result. Do you think they're overlooking you here at the moment?
I hope so. I don't know. I hope they're overlooking me. They got one of the best fighters in the world in front of them. But not paying attention to anything Rios is saying or doing. Listen, Rios' only opportunity is the opportunity that I give him. That's his only opportunity, the opportunity I give him. Rios ain't gonna make me do something that I don't wanna do, all right? So as long as I'm focused all the way through and I'm doing everything I'm supposed to do and doing it right, you know, and without giving Rios that opportunity, that chance to land that big shot on me, it's gonna be a long night for Rios.
Bradley, with being one of the top fighters in the world, you fought the top fighters. You even sparred the fighters. Two fighters right now, the boxing community wants you to step into the ring. Is Manny Pacquiao versus Terrence Crawford. You fought Manny Pacquiao twice. You sparred Terrence Crawford. If they were to step into the ring, how do you see that fight playing out?
Terrence Crawford winning that fight.
Even though he might not have the opponents to deserve a Pacquiao fight or the experience?
Who else right now at 140 that you can see that can beat Terrence Crawford? Just name it. Name a fighter. Danny Garcia don't want that. Who else? Oh, Danny Garcia actually moved up to 147. I mean, who else at 140 do you see any problems for Terrence Crawford? Yeah. Nobody. At 35, who do you see? Nobody. 47. There's some dogs there, but Terrence can compete with them all. Right. You know, his boxing IQ. I've always said it. His ability to switch righty and lefty. His ability to figure you out. He got good speed, good timing. He's young. He's confident. It's hard to beat a guy like that.
You know
so
what?
I'm going with Terrence Crawford.
Bradley, growing up, I know you saw the fighters at Atlas training before. You were probably even a professional. How surreal is it having him in your corner now, preparing you for this fight?
It's great. It's great. The young master, that's what they called him back in the days. It was Custom Model called him. Yeah. He's back now, man.
Yeah.
And I understand why. Custom Model's one of the best trainers in the world. And Teddy Atlas picked up everything that Custom Model has ever taught and more. Yeah. So when I'm in here working, it's like I feel like Cuss is here with me, because Teddy ain't no joke with it, man. And that's what I need, man. I need that focus. I need that you know, someone that cares that much, you know, to make sure I'm doing what's right in the ring and you know, stopping a sparring session and correcting this and correcting that. It's just gonna make me a better fighter.
Bradley, you yourself have graced the cover of Ring Magazine. There's a little bit of uproar from the boxing world with the Ring Magazine putting Ronda Rousey in the front cover. What's your take on that? Why would the people be upset at that? Isn't that somewhat of a historical thing for Ring TV and benefit?
Well, I don't know about, you know, the whole politics of that, but Ronda Rousey is the baddest lady on the planet, so I don't see why it's a bad look. She's one of the baddest ladies on the planet.
Yeah.
I mean, what's the disrespect there?
Yeah.
I don't understand it, but, you know how people are, you know how things are, politics. It's just the way of life. Yeah. Sometimes we got to deal with that, but I don't see a problem with it.
Bradley, you know Diaz well. He's trained for him for a long time. You know Provodnikov well. You fought him once. They've teamed up now. Do you think Carl Diaz can make any changes in Provodnikov?
I don't know. I don't know, and I don't care.
Okay. Thank you, Bradley. Appreciate your time.
Thank you.